Good morning, students. Welcome to class 7 civics class. Today we will discuss the first chapter of civics. In class 8, the first chapter of civics is the Indian Constitution. Now the question comes, what is the Constitution? Actually, in definition we can say it is a collection of rules or set of rules according to which a government runs its country. It is a set of rules or collection of rules according to which a country is governed or a country is ruled. This rule is applicable everywhere, in our family, in school, in any big institutions, even in the games. You people are very fond of playing the cricket and watching the cricket match. Cricket match also has certain rules. These certain rules, in what conditions a player, means batsman, will get out, whether it is a no ball or correct ball, whether it is a wide ball, whether it is a four or it is hit by six, there are different conditions that comes. Not only cricket, it is applicable in all the games. It means each game has its own rules and regulations. These rules and regulations may be called the constitution of that game. In the same way, in our family, in the political parties, they have certain rules and regulation. Like in the political party, you might have been seeing the TV news, TV debate, that a particular person is coming to explain the idea of his or her political party. It means only that person has been appointed to explain. No one can go against his verdict. Since no one is allowed to go against this verdict, you can say it is a constitution. It means everywhere, whether in our family, in our family also, the guidelines are given by the head of the family, whether it may be our father, maybe grandfather, who are giving the direction to run the family, where to go, where to visit, how much relations we have to keep with others. It means all it is in guiding, it is not written, it is not in the form of written. In the same way, a country becomes a very big area. To run a country, it is necessary that certain rules and regulations are to be imposed, implemented. They make a collection. This collection of set of rules and regulations is called constitution. Before I go, start now comes, we have got all the definition of the constitution. Then why a country need a constitution? Why does a country need a constitution? Constitution ki zarurat country ko kyon ho jati? There are certain points that has been mentioned over here. These are points which explains why a country needs a constitution. says, it tells us the type of government in a country. What type of government it is? Whether it is a monarchy or democracy. You will read in the higher classes, there are constitutional monarchy also. What does the word constitutional monarchy mean? Constitutional monarchy means the head is the monarch, is ruler, but they follow the constitution that is framed by the parliament. Now you may ask, why is it not happening earlier? If it is not the constitutional monarchy, it is simply a monarchy government. Then whatever the rulers use to say it, speak it out, it becomes the rule. There was no any written verdict. It means whatever it was being explained by the rulers, it was becoming simply the rule. But this is the basic difference between the monarchy and the constitutional monarchy. In the constitutional monarchy, the monarch has to act according to the constitution. England, we have the constitutional monarchy. Bhutan, we have the constitutional monarchy. For a short period of time, Nepal had a constitutional monarchy. It tells us whether it is the constitutional monarchy or it is a democratic one. Our country is an example of democratic country where the head of the state and members are elected. Both the representatives in constitutional monarchy also, the representative are elected, but the head of the state are not elected, that they are either king or queen. But in our system, it says whether it is a democratic, in democratic, whether it is a republic or not. In the case sense of republic, it is head of the state is an elected member. It means it tells us the type of government in a country, what type of government do we have. Then what the next thing it explains? It tells us the fundamental nature of the society. What is the fundamental nature of the society? How we are being governed? Who will govern us? In your book, textbook, one example is given regarding the Nepal. In the Nepal, earlier the country was, society was ruled by the constitutional monarch. Later on, it was ruled by the constitution itself. Who is ruling? Who is ruling the society? Because individuals are a part of society, they make the society according to the society. It is very much understandable to us that what type of government might have been ruling this. Simply if I take your example to the North Korea, as the people are getting the freedoms, we don't know. It is a type of societies that we are finding. The society of North Korea, you will find it is quite different from us. They have the constitution, we have the constitution, but their constitution is different from ours because it explains about the fundamental nature of the society. The third one, the thought says that it tells us country's political system. What do you mean by the country's political system? The country's political system simply explains that थोड़ा सा कंफ्यूजन हुआ. डेमोक्रेटिक गवर्नमेंट आर टू टाइप्स. वन इज पार्लियामेंट्री फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट. इन द पार्लियामेंट्री फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट द रिप्रेजेंटेटिव आर इलेक्टेड एट द सेम टाइम एंड रूल इज प्रेसिडेंट इज ऑल्सो इलेक्टेड एट द सेम टाइम. द वर्क इज डन बाय द पार्लियामेंट. इट मीन्स पार्लियामेंट इज मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड अदर वन इज द प्रेसिडेंशियल फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट. इन द प्रेसिडेंशियल फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट प्रेसिडेंट बिकम्स मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट. वी टेक द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ USA, America. America has presidential form of government and we have parliamentary form of government. It is told to us by the constitution. It tells us country's political system. Then it explains a chapter on fundamental rights in our constitution also. The chapter is explained. The fundamental rights are mentioned in part 3 of the Indian Constitution. We will explain it later on. What the fundamental rights are there? These are the rights. Rights means adhikar. These are the rights which are approved by society and guaranteed by constitution. If anybody asks you what we mean by the fundamental rights, these are those rights which are approved by society and guaranteed by constitution. Why these rights are necessary? These rights are necessary for the overhaul development of the people. Freedom has been given fundamental rights. Equalities are mentioned. Freedom, the most important thing is freedom is mentioned. Freedom has a the different types of freedoms are there. The most important freedoms that we analyze, it is right to speech and expression. Right to speech and expression means that you have got the right to explain your view, your idea regarding the government also. You have got the right that if you think that the policy of the government is not good, you may criticize the policy of the government. Aap uska criticize kar sakte hain. Generally, do we criticize? Not saying hum karte nahi karte, ghar mein karte hain, pata chalta hai ki nahi chalta. Political party ka to dekho, jo opposition party kya karti hai? They simply criticizing the policy of the government, whatever policy they are being implemented, opposition party will criticize. We people also criticize. We express our feelings by doing the dharna, chakka jam, hartal, etc. that you have made. It means it has given. We can occupy any occupation that we think it is according to our rights. We can go anywhere in the territory of India and settle down. Few times back, people had no right to go and settle down in Jammu and Kashmir. It was the exception. But now one can settle down. It means we can go anywhere. If you see your surrounding, if you are living in the city, I am not talking about the village. If you are living in the city, you will find, if you ask your neighbors, where are you from? They will say, I am from the another district or another state. Maybe from another district or from another state. If they found themselves better in your city, in this city, where they are living it, they have the right, got the right. No one can stop them from doing so. That we have got, it explains the chapter on the fundamental rights. We may criticize, we may go anywhere, we may assemble, we may have political parties, and many rights are given that when the term will come, we will discuss it. It explains, the next is, it explains that a dominant groups means whose number is more, whose population is more, on the basis of religion, on the basis of community. It explains, what does it explain? It explains that a dominant groups means majority groups does not use its power against less powerful peoples. Suppose that in a country two or three communities are living. In these two or three communities, one is in majority. And if one is in majority, then it is possible that they may frame a law which would support them, but which may have the less powerful peoples. Even the richer one, even the peoples belonging to a particular community may use their power in such a way that they may harm the other groups. It is the constitutions that stop it, protect the less powerful peoples from the dominant group of the society. Then it also contains rules that ensure that minority are not excluded. Unko hataya nahi ja sakta, chhoda nahi ja sakta hai. From anything that is routinely available to the majority, jo rights, whatever rights that are available to majority, it is also available to the minority. Yes, for your jobs. Indian society is the male dominated society. Indian society is the male dominated society, used to be, not from today, from the very back. बहुत बैक में जाएंगे तो वहाँ मदर का इम्पोर्टेंस था ज़्यादा. इफ यू गो टू द बेसिक एज उसमें मदर का इम्पोर्टेंस ज़्यादा, लेकिन उसके बाद बन गया ये हमारा पैट्रिशियल सोसाइटी, मतलब कि फादर का इम्पोर्टेंस ज़्यादा. इन दिस मेल डोमिनेटेड सोसाइटी इट बिकम्स वेरी हार्ड फॉर द women to come in the limelight. The less propitious groups, why the less money, less number in area, becomes difficult, it is difficult for them to contest election and win it. Because our society is divided on the basis of religion, and in each region it is divided on the basis of caste, and the number of caste is different. It has been further divided into upper caste and lower caste. So it is contains rules you will find for the SC and ST groups. Scheduled caste and scheduled tribe. Scheduled tribes are very, very much minority numbers. And practically, if we say, if the political election take place and they are contesting freely, that becomes difficult for them to win that election. Bahut mushkil hai. Constitution ne provision bana diya hai. Provision kya bana diya hai? Seats have been reserved. For example, parliamentary elections mein अभी फिलहाल एससी के लिए 24 और एसटी के लिए 47 फॉर एससी 84 सीट्स एंड एसटी 47 सीट्स आर रिजर्व इट मींस व्हाट एवर पॉलिटिकल पार्टी वांट इज कंटेस्टिंग व्हाट विल द कैंडिडेट विल बी बिलोंगिंग टू आइदर एससी और एसटी इट हैज बीन प्रोवाइडेड Success has been given in the constitution. Then it saves us from ourselves. हमको हमी से बचाता है. तो फनी लगा. हमको हमी से क्या बचाता है? It gives us the indication and the guideline and direction for a particular act. You might get a particular type of punishment. It has been given, it indicates, it directs us. वो मत करो, punishment मिलेगी. Road पे जा रहे हैं, left side में चलना है, right side में चलेंगे, punishment तो मिलेगी. Vehicle का insurance नहीं करवाया, punishment तो मिलेगी. It means Everything else, if we want to protect ourselves, reckless driving, punishment, it means if we know that if we are doing this act, we would be sent to jail or we may given a certain punishment, then we will not do it. It means it simply saves us. और प्रोटेक्ट अस फ्रॉम द आवरसेल्व्स ये हमको हमी से बचाता है इट रिस्ट्रिक्ट इट कंट्रोल्स इट गाइड अस डोंट इंडल्ज योरसेल्फ इन अ पर्टिकुलर एक्टिविटी इट मींस इन एवरी एस्पेक्ट ऑफ आवर लाइफ फ्रॉम द पॉलिटिकल सिस्टम टिल द ग्रासरूट लेवल्स That is related to our activities. Everywhere we find that constitution is necessary. That's why to run a big country, to control a very big population, it is very necessary that a country should have a constitution. It means we have got the definition of constitution. Now we have got Why a country needs a constitution? No. Indian constitution, framing of the Indian constitution. Just we know that India become the colony of British rule. Just to recall, do you remember the Battle of 1757? It was the classic 1764 Battle But sir, after that company rule started. When the company rule started, we have already discussed it was becoming difficult for them to rule the country. Because their society is quite different from ours. It tells us the fundamental nature of the society. this fundamental nature of reading is quite different from ours, so it was getting difficult for them to vote. They were continuously making their laws and they were implementing it, amending it, generally after a gap of 10 years. But 1857 onward, you will read in the history, the revolt of 1857, the people had rebelled. Then the system changed and instead of company rule, it became the rule of public. Nationalist movement increased in India. They were demanding the constitution. They were also demanding the freedom. In constitution, demanding the constitution, and in constitution, the most important thing, equality and universal adult franchise was the main topic or main agenda. Equality, because our society is a diverse society. This gain cabinet mission. Now a proposal for the making of the constitution, because the political party is in the England Labour Party. England had a two-party system. One is Tory party, another one is the Labour Party. Labour Party had the soft corner for the Indians, so they were planning to grant the independence to the Indians. So in cabinet missions that arrived India in and gave the proposal of making the constitution. They give the threats that they would grant independence any time before June 1948. That time period. Time period June 1948. कहा गया कि June 1948 तक we may transfer the powers and it becomes necessary for you, what is necessary to frame your own constitution. आप अपना constitution बना लीजिए, अपना संविधान बना लीजिए कि मेरे डिपार्ट के बाद it depends on you because my law, my constitution will go with us. In July 1946, election for Constituent Assembly held on a single transferable vote from both. Both means princely estate and the provincial estate. Provincial estate, provincial that we are talking about, we have discussed, it was under the direct control of the British Parliament. There were 8 provinces, including the Pakistan, Bangladesh and India. Others were princely estate. At the time of independence, we have 562 princely estates. In July 1946, elections were held, and in elections for all of India, it were 389 members. 389 members were held for whole country, including the Pakistan, today's Bangladesh. The elections were held, and in these elections, 389 members were held. Its first meeting took place on 9th December 1946 and Dr.
S.N. Sinha. He was made the temporary president of Constituent Assembly. Then on 11th December 1946,
Constitution of UK, constitution of Russia, France, Germany, Ireland, Australia. It means many countries. And among things, whatever topics were discussed, if your finding was better one, which is applicable, after dissertation, it was being transferred to the drafting committee, and drafting committee was enrolling it under the different headings. In the next class, we will discuss features of the Indian Constitution. This class is over.